Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial on creating a banner in Illustrator. We're going to make this banner from scratch, so I've already created a document. It's in RGB color mode and it's 1000 pixels by 1000 pixels, but your image could be any size you like. We're going to start with a rectangle, so I'm just going to click on the rectangle tool and I'm going to drag out a rectangle, and this is going to be the sort of loopy bit of the banner, so you're going to want to make it about the size that you want your banner to be. I'm going to fill it with a color and I'm going to remove the stroke, but before we go too far, let's have a look at the colors that we're going to use. What I'm going to do is sample a blue color to use. So let's just select my shape. I'm going to double click on the color here and I'm going to select a sort of blue to use. Now I'm going to choose the darkest blue that I want to use at this point. So let's call that good. Now I'm going to the color guide panel and it's over here, but you can also get to it by choosing window and then color guide. Now when you select a color and go to the color guide, you'll see here that you get shades and tints of the color. If you're not seeing those, you can just come in here to the flyout menu and choose shades and tints. And this is what I want. I want these colors to be the colors that I get to choose from. So I'm clicking on one and then holding the shift key down as I click on the last one. So I have all of these colors selected from the flyout menu here. I'm just going to choose save colors as swatches. Now when I go to the swatches palette, you'll see that I have these colors saved as a swatch. Now let me reselect my rectangle. I'm going to choose this color for the actual banner, but I've got some adjacent colors that can be used for other elements. Now while I've got this shape already created, I'm just going to Alt or Option drag a duplicate away. I just need to tuck another piece away for safekeeping. I'm going to shorten it a little bit widthwise, but I'm going to leave the height as exactly the same height as this piece here. You want to keep these two pieces the same height. So let's focus on this piece here. What I want to do is to make it a little bit wavy. So with it selected, I'm going to choose Object, and then I'll choose Envelope Distort, Make with Warp. This gives me access to a whole heap of warp options that are built into Illustrator. And the one I'm going to use here right now is Flag. So from the style drop-down list, I'm just selecting Flag. Now I want it to be adjusted in a horizontal direction, so I'm going to select horizontal. And I could choose any value here, so I'm just looking at what I'm going to get. And I'm just looking to see if I can get a shape that's going to be pleasing to me. So you can go in a negative or a positive percentage value on this blend slider to get what you want. When you're happy with it, click OK. Right now we have a shape that has a warp applied to it, and you'll see that whenever we select it, we've still got these sort of warp lines on it. We need to get rid of those, so I'm going to choose Object and then Expand. Now I just want to expand the object, not the fill, so I'm just going to click Object and click OK. And that gives me an object now that is not subject to that removable warp. But if we have a look at it by selecting on it with the direct selection tool, you'll see that it's got a very, very thick blue outline. And the reason for this is that there are lots and lots of anchor points here, way, way more than we need. So back to the selection tool, select over the shape, and let's choose Object Path Simplify. The Simplify tool allows us to reduce the number of points on a path, making it a lot simpler than it was. With preview turned on, I've got my angle threshold set to 0. My curve precision is sort of up around the 80s, but you can make it whatever value you like. The original shape had 268 points on it, and now it only has 10 anchor points. Much, much simpler shape to be working with, so I'll just click OK. Now let's focus on this little piece here, which is going to be the tail of this banner. And we're going to make two out of it, but before we do, let's go and make it the right shape. So with it selected, I'm going to choose Object Path and then Add Anchor Points. That adds some extra anchor points around the shape, in particular an anchor point over here in the middle of this side. If I select the direct selection tool, I can now click on that anchor point and just drag it in to make that telltale little V shape in the end of my rectangle. So this is going to be part of my banner. When I'm happy with that, I'll select over it and we're going to warp this too. Object, Envelope Distort, Make with Warp. We're not going to use flag this time because that's giving us a bit too much of a bend. I'm going to use rise. Now with rise, you can experiment with the values you're going to use. You're going to want to do horizontal because vertical just is nonsense for this particular project. But you may want your rise to go in different directions. I'm going to settle for one that's going sort of up in this direction, but you can make a choice as to what works best for you. I'll click OK. Now I'm thinking that this shape is probably a bit too big, so I'm going to shorten it a little bit before I progress any further. With it selected, I'm again going to expand it to get rid of these warp lines. Object, expand. I'm just going to expand the object, not the fill, and I'll click OK. Again, this one's going to have lots and lots of anchor points, so selecting it, I'm going to choose Object and then Path and Simplify. It has 122 points. I can reduce it down to a lot less than that. Just want to get sort of a strong edge here, and for this I'm going to set my curve precision to 100%. My angle threshold is 0. I'm getting 22 points, but I think it's worth it to get these edges nice and sharp. So I'll click OK. Again, with the selection tool still selected, I'm just going to move this into position a little bit. I want to recolor it, so the fill color is at the 4, so let's just go and apply a slightly darker color to it. You can see that right now it's in front of the sort of banner shape I want to put it behind. So I'll choose Object, Arrange, and then Send to Back, and that puts it behind the banner itself. And at this point, I can sort of move it into position wherever I want it to be, and I could even rotate it a little bit should I wish to. I need a second one of these over here, so the easiest way to do that is just to make a duplicate of this. I'll choose Object, Transform, and then Reflect, because I want this one to go in the opposite direction, so I'll choose Horizontal as the reflection. So that was the original, this is going to be the duplicate. Because I want a second one of these, I'm going to click Copy. Let's take our duplicate over here, and of course we need to flip it over the vertical. So let's choose Object, Transform, and we'll choose Reflect and then Vertical. And it's pointing in the right direction, so I'll just click OK. I don't need to click Copy this time because I've already got the copy I need. Now at this point I'm just going to place it into position, and if I need to, I could just straighten it up a little bit. At this point, if you think the element is a little bit long, you can scrunch it up. It doesn't matter if these two are different lengths because that just gives it a slightly more organic look. The next thing we need to do is to add the shading in behind these. So I'm going to zoom in here. I'm going to select the zoom tool and just zoom in so we can see the area we're working in. I'm going to use the pen tool to do this. Now, a lot of people really hate the pen tool, but it's fairly easy job for the pen tool in this case. With the pen tool selected, you're going to hover over this anchor point here, and you'll see the word anchor appear when you hover over it. So you're just going to click and drag. So don't let go of the left mouse button until you've actually clicked and dragged. And we're going to go off in the direction we're headed in, which is sort of over here. So I've got that first point, now I'm going to get the second point, again hovering over the anchor point in the corner here and just clicking and dragging to make a nice sort of loop here. Now you can see that right now I've got the rubber band showing, but you can see that the direction I'm headed off in is not a happy one. I want to go down here and everything's sort of bending. Well, I can make this come with me if I hold the Alt key on a PC, the Option key on a Mac. And I'm just going to hover over the handle and just drag it down until it's in the right line, the line I want to head off in, and then I'll let go. Now I'm going to come down here and I'm just going to make this shape. I need to keep inside this banner piece here, but I just want to make a sort of larger shape, much more of a shape than I actually need, but that's fine because it's going to tuck in behind everything. With the shape now selected, I'm just going to click on it to select it. I can make it a darker color. So let's go and make it this darker color. We're also going to push it behind everything with Object, Arrange, and we're just going to do Send backwards this time. We don't want to send it to the back because that would send it behind this piece. It needs to be sandwiched between these two pieces. Now let's go to the other end of the banner and do the exact same thing again with the pen tool. Click on the pen tool. I'm going to click here to start my shape. I'm going to click and drag. I'm going to head off in the approximate direction I want to go in. I'm going to get to here, click and drag. I'm not going to let go of the left mouse button because I have to swing this handle around. So I'll hold the Alt or Option key as I swing it around to point in the direction of the edge of this lighter blue piece of the banner. Let go of the left mouse button, let go the Alt or Option key. Now I'm going to come up here and make my shape. And just close up the shape. It's the right color. I'm going to the selection tool. I'll choose object, arrange, and then send backwards again. I just want it to be sandwiched between these two shapes, not sent to the very back. I'm going to hold down the control key command on a Mac and press the number 0. That just zooms everything back out. At this point, we can have a look in the layers palette and see what we've got because it's not a totally pretty sight. It's going to make my layer options a little bit larger here so that we can see what's going on. And you'll see that I've got a few groups here, but if I open up these groups, each of those groups has only got one object in it, so they're unnecessary groups. So with my entire shape selected, I'm just going to choose object ungroup and make sure that now I just have individual paths. I like to keep my layers palette as clean and clear as possible so I don't have just single objects inside groups when that doesn't make any sense. At this point, I could put this entire object in a group now, so just select it and choose object group, and then I would have a banner that I could use. Now I'm just going to undo that because I want to show you something, because some people might be a little bit concerned that I have a piece that is sort of this shape when it really should perhaps in their minds be the cutout shape that we see in the actual drawing. So let me just undo that. If you want this shape piece to be just that shape, you'll select on this object and you need to make a duplicate of it. Edit copy, edit paste in place. It's critical that it's pasted in place. With it selected, you can hold down the shift key as you click on this shape that you want to make into sort of just a smaller triangular shape. With those two objects selected, you can see I've got the path here and this shape selected. I'm going to the Pathfinder tool. If you don't see the Pathfinder here, choose Window and then Pathfinder. What I'm going to do here is click on Minus Front, and that's going to use this larger piece to clip away the unnecessary portion of the one behind. And you can see now that's the piece that I've got. If you didn't make a duplicate before you did that, you'd have lost this piece entirely. So we could do the same over here. Select on this one, choose Edit Copy, Edit Paste in Place, critical step there. Shift click on this shape to select it, go to the Pathfinder, click Minus Front, and you now have this little piece instead of the larger uneven shape piece. Now if you wanted to do the same thing with the piece behind, you could do that too. I'm going to select this piece and this piece. I need to make a duplicate of them, so I'll choose Edit Copy, Edit Paste in Place. They're still selected, so I'm going to leave them selected as I shift click on this piece here. And again, I'm going back to my Pathfinder, Minus Front. You'll see that the banner looks exactly the same, but this piece has had the extra piece cut out of it. So we could do the same on this side should we wish to. I'm not going to do that at this stage, but I am going to ungroup everything and then regroup it. So I'll choose Object Ungroup just to get rid of these groups. Seem to have got a few paths that I don't really want here. So let's just go and select and delete them. I think they're just extraneous little pieces here. If you find bits that you don't need that are not really helping, you can just get rid of them. Now let's select over everything. Let's group it so that everything is in just a single group. And so we now have our banner element. If you want to be able to use that over and over again, you could save it as a symbol. I'll select over it and I'm going to the symbols palette here. The sensible thing at this point is to select all of your symbols by clicking on the first one, shift click on the last, and just get rid of them. Just drop them all in the trash can. Now let's take our banner and make a symbol of it. So I'm just going to give it the name banner. You don't have to name it if you don't want to. You don't need to select anything here in particular. It's just fine to add it as a symbol. Now at the moment these two objects are connected, so if you make a change to this one you're going to change the symbol. So let's just click here to break the link to the symbol. So they're now independent. We can save this as a symbol file by clicking the flyout menu and choose Save Symbol Library. You'll open up the location where Illustrator saves your symbols to. I'm just going to call this banner and click Save. So it can now be opened and used in any Illustrator document in future. So I now have my banner. I've also got it saved as a symbol that I could use anytime. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial.